Cost, sale of production, and economies of scale. Crazy IGCSE. Welcome back to Crazy IGCSE. For those of you who are new to my channel, hi, this is Crazy IGCSE, where you can study 7 IGCSE subjects at one place. The subjects include IGCSE Biology, Physics, Business, Economics, Accounting, ESL, and maths, also some tips and study hacks. So here is IGCSE at your fingertips. Please do subscribe, like, and comment down below for any queries. So why should we know about the business costs? First, to calculate the profit or loss of the business. Second is to help make decisions in the business, that is mainly for managers. Then average costs is equal to the total cost divided by the output, and the total cost is equal to the fixed cost plus the variable cost. Now there are three types of costs: fixed cost, variable cost, and total cost. So fixed costs are those costs that don't change with the change in output or sales. And variable costs, these are costs which change according to the output or the sales. The total cost is the cost which includes the variable and fixed cost together, so which is basically the sum of variable and fixed cost is total cost. Average cost is the total cost of production divided by the total output, which is also known as unit cost. How business use the classified costs? They use it to set prices of goods. So if a pizza is sold for $3 and the business needs to make a profit of $2, so they will have to sell their pizza for $5, so 5 minus 3 will be 2, so they get a profit of $2. Now the second point is that the decision made to know whether the production should continue or stop. So now the business will get to know whether the product is being sold or not, because if it is not being it's not in demand by the customers, then that's going to increase the costs for the business. So thus they could stop the production of that product. So the cost is really important to know whether the production needs to continue or stop. Although if a company launches a product into the market, and that is a new product in the market, so it is likely that there may not be very high sales at the start, but then later on, as the price is lower, people may start buying the product, so that will increase the sales. So business have to keep this also in mind. Then it is also used for deciding on the location. So the fixed cost will be the location's rent. So based on that, they will decide on the location as well. Economies of scale are factors which lead to a lower average cost as the business is growing in size. Now, there are 5 economies of scale. So these are basically the advantages of a large business. First is purchasing economies. Purchasing economies means buying in bulk. The business has enough money to buy in bulk. Now, when they buy products or raw materials in bulk, that's when they get more discount. Then marketing economies is lower advertising costs. Now the business is already known, so they don't have to spend most of their money on advertising. Then financial economies, it is easy to take a loan. So the business is a well-known business and it is known to pay back loans. So thus the bank will be willing to lend them loans. Managerial economies means they can afford specialists. Now specialists include the efficiency of the business, and small businesses are likely not to afford these specialists. So as a large business, they can afford the specialist. Then technical economies, they can afford the latest technology which will improve the efficiency of the business and increase output and sales. Diseconomies of scale are the factors which lead to an increase in average cost as the business grows in size. So these are basically the disadvantages of having a large business. The first one is poor communication. So there'll be many chain of command. There'll be a long chain of command. So it's very hard for a information to be passed on to the employees. Then lack of commitment from employees. So the employee may not get to meet the top managers or the owner himself. Thus, they may get demotivated. Weak coordination, longer time to make decisions which reach the large businesses employees. It will take a lot of time for a particular information to reach all the employees. Break-even level of output. This is when the quantity which needs to be produced in order to make the revenue and total costs are equal. This break-even level of output is also known as the break-even point. So this is a break-even chart. It is a graph which shows how the cost and revenue change with sales. Now, the revenue will start from zero as well as the variable cost. Now, the fixed cost will be a horizontal line and the variable cost and fixed cost will be equal to the total cost. Now, the line which the two lines, revenue and cost, the point where they intersect is called the break-even level of output. The calculation of break-even point is, first we need to find the contribution. To find a contribution, you will have to do selling price minus the variable cost. After that, you will have to find the break-even point. For that, you will have to do total fixed cost divided by the contribution. Revenue is the quantity sold into the price. That's when you get your total revenue. Margin of safety is the amount by which the sales will exceed the break-even point. Now, it is important for the business to produce more than the break-even point. Because if they produce at break-even point, then they will not get a profit nor loss. However, if they increase that output, then they're it's likely that they make a profit. So the advantage of break-even charts is that the managers will be able to read whether the business is going to expect a profit or a loss. Second, the impact of profit or loss can be shown by redrawing the graph. It also shows the margin of safety and shows the break-even level of output. It helps managers in decision-making. Disadvantages include it's made by assuming that all output is sold. Now, it is also possible that all output is not sold, so the data may be incorrect. Then the scale of production will not change. Then there are many other aspects of operations of a business which needs to be analyzed apart from the break-even chart. Then assuming that the cost and revenue can be drawn with straight lines. Now, it is also possible that the fixed cost does not remain constant. It may change. So this is the end of our video. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe, like, and comment down below. I hope you found this information useful.